Starting a new thing. It can be fun and exciting, but it can also be daunting and scary. Learning how to ride a bike, learning how to walk, learning how to do school or work or church in a pandemic. Sometimes we can get so focused on trying to reach the goal that we get sidetracked or worried and try really hard to find our own way to figure it out. We likely didn't expect a lot of what's going on right now. We've started a new thing. Abraham definitely didn't expect God to pick him to be the father of Israel. At age 75, he probably thought he was on the last lap, but he had a long way to go. And to be honest, the disciples in today's gospel were lucky. Jesus was there, visibly, to say, "I am going to be with you. Here's what you need to do." And they still had a hard time figuring it out. We know from our experience and from the scriptures today that hearing and responding to the call is no sprint. It's a triathlon. That is likely how the Southern Black Americans felt when they journeyed from Georgia to the North and found that the work of freedom was not done. It was only getting started. That's why we need to, as people, sing to each other and remind each other that God will be with us through every step of the journey. He was there guiding Abraham. He was there with the disciples, and he is here now, calling us all to receive his many blessings and guiding our feet through every step. God reminds us that we can do hard things. Sometimes he grants us glimpses of his glorious kingdom and the blessings we experience in our lives to encourage us and spur us on. But our main focus should be staying close to God. God will set the pace in keeping with our needs and his purpose for us in this world. He chose me and you to walk with him along paths designed uniquely for us. If we concentrate on keeping in step with God, instead of trying to anticipate his plans for us, then we can relax and enjoy the present moment, even during difficult and unpredictable times. And we can remind each other of this by singing songs, like this freedom song, "Guide My Feet," which has brought heart, mind, and spirit together for decades in the journey towards hope and liberation. Musician and cultural historian Bernice Johnson Reagan put the effect of singing together best when she wrote, "After the song, the differences among us would not be so great." Let us join our voices and sing this song, this call to God, to guide our steps in this journey of faith together.
Yeah.